quantum computing is at the stage that the science looks well understood, and the challenges of building something that might be useful are engineering challenges. The vision of the hub is to take that underlying science and address what are the what will be the first stage of the long-term development of a quantum computer by looking at the engineering required to scale the systems we have to a level at which we can convince people these really are scalable. So the numbers we've chosen are to take to try and build a system of a scale of 400 qubits. We chose 400 qubits as a goal that was challenging, achievable, and would convince people that the system would be scalable to a higher level of scale. The approach we're taking is to try and build a network of 20 nodes, each with 20 qubits stored within it, using ions as the storage medium. The connections will be made using photons, using light. We have resources to help our partners, who we have already, and new partners, do two things. One is understand our technology needs and try and provide technologies for us. And the second thing is for us to help them understand what quantum might mean, about what quantum computing might mean for their business in the future. So you imagine a financial institution asking a very broad question, what would quantum computing mean in 20 years' time for us? We can address that question with the resources and the team that we have. We also work closely with the other hubs. What we really want to do is pass on the questions we get asked to the best people to answer them. That's one thing. The second thing we want to do is make sure we link up with the other hubs to address common engineering challenges together. I think the exact timescales are very difficult to estimate. I'd rather set out what I think is a sort of roadmap towards that. At a small scale, maybe even the 400 qubit scale, there'll be particular classes of problem that you might be able to address using such a machine, which would be the best way to do that problem. So we're interested in things like quantum simulation. That's very specific classes of material where this approach might be a good way to model them. That's one thing. Quantum machine learning might be an area where these modest scale machines would be very helpful. So we have sort of phase one of small scale specialist processes, if you will. I think the grand general purpose large scale quantum computing engine, if you like, just simply because of the scale that we need for it, it is some way off in the future. There's an interesting thing about differences in scale. So you might imagine the grand large quantum computer is going to be like a Google server farm. So the market for that is going to be of a similar scale to the market for Google server farms. There won't be many around the world. You won't need to be close to one. The network will connect you to that sort of thing. For smaller scale quantum computers, you can see a wider market for that. I think it's unrealistic to think in any kind of century-long timescale we're going to see the quantum computers as in your phone or something like that. Silicon does that job very well. So, but you'll see this medium-scale but substantial market in more specialist co-processors or hybrid classical quantum, and then a smaller market in these larger-scale things, I think.